Kevin, thank you. The Colts are getting ready for the weekend. This one sees them traveling to Chicago to face the Bears. Indy has looked very good in their last two games, both wins, but they've got a new look offense on the across the field this week. Brad Brown has a week four preview.
The Colts have gained some momentum in the right direction after a pair of impressive wins, and now they're trying to harness that positive vibe.
It is head down and focused, and now, you know, the guys have a lot of fun and enjoy wins for sure, but it's just been very steady, focused approach, and I'm not saying that that doesn't surprise me, but I was just, that was one thing I found out now being kind of getting into the regular groove of the season.
Steady is a good way to describe Philip Rivers in these two Colts victories. The quarterback connecting on nearly 80% of his passes. Tight end Mo Alie-Cox continues to be his favorite target, but add Darius Fountain to the receptions column. Sunday saw his first NFL catch in a career that's been riddled by injuries and roadblocks.
It's been a lot of ups and downs within my career, and then the ankle injury was just the cherry on top with all of that, man. So I definitely have a lot of confidence. I'm just treating every day like it's a game. You know, obviously over the past few years, I've been able to play in a lot of games. So I was just taking that energy.
Rookie running back Jonathan Taylor has fully embraced his starting role. He continues grinding out the yards in any way he can.
You know, when you go out into open field, you have to make it count. But it definitely is an adjustment, but you got to understand it. It's big boy football now. So, you know, 4 yards or better is acceptable, but you know, you definitely want to get out into that open field and, you know, kind of show your talents.
Week four sees the Bears on the Colts game plan. A surprise 3-0 for Chicago, perhaps, but the way they got that third win was certainly unexpected. Mitch Trubisky benched after a dismal first half. Nick Foles came in at quarterback and led a big comeback, immediately earning the Bears' starting spot.
Nick is fearless in the pocket. He's one of those quarterbacks who stands in the pocket and the rush doesn't bother him. You know, he'll stand there till the last second, you know, in order, because he sees something coming open down the field and he knows he can make the throw like he did last week.
And what about these empty stadiums? Soldier Field will have none of what would have likely been 60,000 raucous voices. Home field advantage feels like a lot less in the NFL this fall.
I think the communication is the biggest thing. The offenses aren't putting that, you know, we would work silent count all week this week if there were fans. Therefore, we can keep on the verbal cadence. So those are the little things that you felt so far.
This starts a stretch of games that could tell us a lot about the Colts. 3 out of 4 on the road with the bye week squeezed in there. Chances are Indy will be favored in all of these games. They're 2.5-point favorites this week. As for that next home game, Lucas Oil Stadium is upping its capacity to 12,500. Those tickets are on sale now for the Colts and the Jets on Sunday, October 18th. Brad Brown, WRTV Sports.